Hello friends, welcome to my kitchen. This is Shuli and I am going to show you how to make market style tomato sauce or ketchup. You can see its texture. It's same as the ketchup we buy from market. So let's start the recipe. At first we need nice red tomatoes. I have taken 1/2 kg of tomatoes, washed them properly and cut them into pieces. Now we'll add about 1 cup of water to boil the tomatoes. Don't add much water. I have added 1 cup of water. Here I have taken some tamarind to use with it. We can use tamarind pulp too. So now we have to boil the tomatoes. You can see I have put the vessel on induction. Now we have to boil the tomatoes for 10 to 15 minutes. We'll boil them with a lid and stir them occasionally. After a few minutes, I am opening the lid and I'll stir them. Stir the tomatoes with a spoon so that the tomatoes can be boiled evenly. Now we'll cover the vessel again and boil the tomatoes until it's soft. After about 15 minutes, you can see friends, the tomatoes are boiled properly. We'll check it once to be sure. Yes, it's perfect. Now we'll turn the heat off. My G-coil induction remains hot even after turning the heat off. Whatever. After turning the heat off, we'll add the tamarind here into the tomatoes and cover the vessel again and let it cool down. Now everything is in normal temperature. Now we'll add them into a large mixer jar and make a fine puree. You can see friends, I have made a smooth puree and now we have to strain it out to get a smoother puree so that our sauce can be super smooth as like market sauce. So we need a vessel and a strainer to strain it. I have taken a steel saucepan and a strainer. At first I took aluminium top and I was wrong. Don't take aluminium or iron vessels. Take steel or non-stick vessel for cooking any kind of sour thing. So we'll strain the puree with the help of a spoon. We'll add a little water washing the mixer jar and strain the puree again. You can see friends, I have strained the puree very nicely. And now we'll throw out the leftover. Now we have to put the vessel on heat to cook. So let's do it. I have put the vessel on heat and you can see the consistency. It's perfect for a sauce. So we'll add a little water so that the sauce doesn't be so much thick. You can see that I have added a little water. Now we have to boil this mixture for 10 to 15 minutes on medium heat. We'll add 1/2 cup of sugar for 1/2 kg of tomatoes. You can see friends, I have taken 1/2 cup of sugar. Where our tomatoes were of 1/2 kg. So I have added it. And we'll add 1/2 teaspoon of salt or salt to taste. We'll add more salt if needed after we taste it. Here I am adding 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder. You can skip it if you don't want spicy sauce. You can also add paprika powder or red food color for a bright color, but I am not adding it. will mix it nicely. And here I have taken 1 tablespoon of corn flour. I'll add a little water in it and make a smooth batter. The batter should have no lumps. We'll keep the batter aside and use it later. So now we'll check the taste of the sauce. The salt, sugar or tamarind should be perfect. So we'll check it. So I think it needs a little more salt and a little more tamarind. So I have added 1/2 teaspoon of salt again. And I'll add a little piece of tamarind in it. And after it is soft, I'll take it out and make a pulp and add into the sauce. So I'm taking it out, making a pulp, and strain the pulp into the sauce. Now you can see that the consistency is perfect, and it's time to add the corn flour batter, and we'll get the market sauce style smoothness. We'll stir the batter again and pour it into the sauce. Mix it properly and the sauce will get very smooth, as like the market sauce. At the end, we'll add 1/2 cup of white vinegar in it, and it will help us store the sauce for 2 months. After adding the vinegar, we have to boil the sauce again for 2 to 3 minutes to make the consistency perfect again. Remember that the sauce will get thicker after cooling down. So now it's perfect. And now I'm going to show you the smoothness of the sauce. I have taken a plate and pouring some sauce on it. You can see that it's perfectly smooth as the market sauce. So we'll turn the heat off and let it cool down. After cooling down the ketchup, we'll store it in a bottle or an airtight container. Don't use any kind of metal container to store it. So the recipe is very easy. Please try it at home. And if you try the recipe, please let me know about your experience. So no more today, friends. If you like the video, please hit the like button and please subscribe to my channel to get more videos from me. Thank you so much for watching.